Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Would you join me in our call to worship? And if you're able, would you please stand? Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord a song of strength.
Our strength is in the Lord's host.
Sing to the Lord a song of joy.
Our song is a song of service and faithfulness.
Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is God of Grace, God of Glory, the United Methodist Hymnal 577, verses 1, 2, and 4.
Amen. are. You may wave, smile. May God's peace be with you. Thanks be to God. Amen. Calisita, you want to come here for our children's moment? Are you going to move here? Okay. Shall we sing?
You want to sing?
Yes.
Here we go.
We all sing together. Jesus loves you. Vineyard is a garden of vines. How many of you have seen a vineyard of vines and grapes? Yeah, I think most of you have seen it as you drive to Santa Barbara. You see a lot of grapes and vines. One of my favorite fruits is vine. It's grapes. What about you? What's your favorite fruit? Huh? Mango? What about you, Sita? Watermelon? What about you out there? What's your favorite fruit?
Watermelon?
Mango?
Pineapple.
Yeah, we love to eat fruits and it's good for our body and for our health. Well, God is saying that you are my vineyard. Our church is the image of God's vineyard. And how God talks about his vineyards that he prepared, he take care, and he provides. In Prophet Isaiah's lesson this morning, Prophet Isaiah is telling us how much God loves his vineyard. In John chapter 15, verse 1, Jesus said, I am the vine, you are the branch. So you are God's vineyard. You belong to God. I know school is next week. Sita already returned to school as of Monday. Fanalupe will start school tomorrow. Ofo will start school on Wednesday. And to be God's vineyard, God has not only prepared a place for you, God provides for you, give you gift, give you all the things that he needs. Just like when you plant a little plant, you have to take care, you have to water every day, make sure you have the best seed, put it in the ground, you watch it every day, you water, you prune, you take care, because you're hoping for some fruits, right? And what happens if you take care and you work so hard, but there's no fruits of your mango, or watermelon, or pineapple, or whatever fruits that you plant? You work so hard to take care, right? And then waiting for your plants to bring forth fruits, but it doesn't bring. How do you feel? Sad, exactly. God said that you are my vineyard. I take care of you, provide for you, and hoping that you bring fruits. Just like when your parents sent you to school, expecting you to go and learn and study. Parents work so hard, grandma prayed for you, but what happened if you didn't make it? It's sad because we have hope and we pray and we work so hard. Just like when you go to school, you study and learn and then come to graduation, your name is on the list. You're sad, you feel sad. Our story today reminded us that God loves us so much. How God prepared his vineyard and provide and care for there are nine fruits of spirit that the Bible talks about in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. But those nine fruits is how we live our life and reflect those fruits. One of them is love. The fruit of the spirit is love. You are to love one another. There is joy, to have that joy of the Lord in you so you can reflect that no matter what's happening in your life. If you go back to school, you'll always feel that joy and happiness. There is peace, right? There is patient with everybody. First day of school is hard. Be good. Goodness, kindness, self-control, endurance. Those are the nine fruits of the Spirit. So if you have all that in you, because the Spirit is in you, no matter what's happening in school, you will make it. Amen? Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, thank you for reminding us that we belong to God's vineyard. You have prepared us for this day, for such a time as this. I lift up all our children as they return to school and for those who are already returning to have a successful year of learning. And may you instill the fruits of the Spirit in their mind and their hearts. So no matter what's happening, Lord, they're always love, they're always joyful, they always have patience, they always be kind and always faithful, and they always have patience with one another, self-control, and they're always good. In your name, O Lord. Amen.
Love and mercy, hear our prayers.
children's, and it's a blessing that he shared with us on Thursday night that her daughter, Juliet, is the vice president of her school.
She's the vice principal?
She's the vice principal now.
Yeah. Wow, yes. So not just a psychologist, well, just a psychologist, but along with the psychology,
yes.
She's doing this.
She's an administrator now.
Wow.
So we're so proud of her, and I know she worked so hard for that.
Yeah.
So thanks be to God.
Yeah, and I will add one. I've missed you all the past couple of weeks. I kind of dedicated myself to doctor's appointments this summer. And I got a physical, and I'm turning 48 this year, and so there's a few extra things that come along with that whole thing that you have to do. So I'm sorry that I missed you all the past couple of weeks. I'm getting back a lot of good results. The big complaint is that my good cholesterol is too low. I will take that complaint. I am so grateful. So that's why I haven't been here. It's good to be back. Thank you very much.
Yes, and it's good to see you. We missed you the last two Sundays. Thanks be to God, and you too, Diane. Oh, what a joy and blessing. Continue to pray for Mercy and her mother in the Philippines. Mercy's back home, but things is pretty rough with her and her family. So, Lord, in your love and mercy,
God, prayers.
Continue to pray for Annette's family and people of Myanmar and throughout the world that we need God's peace. So, thanks be to God. Lord, in love and mercy, hear our prayers. Let us come together. I invite you to have a moment of silence. Discern the little voice of God whispering to you.
Each and every child in that school is being a mother.
mother and a wife and a daughter, sister, as being a part of our community. We lift her up to you. We pray for all our children and young people as they return to school. May they find peace, comfort, and surround with your presence. May they reflect the Spirit, the fruits of the Spirit in their lives, and bring joy and peace and be kind and be fair and be loving and be joyful while they learn and develop their gifts that we have provided. May they have a successful school year this year, O Lord. O Lord, we lift up Jacob to you. We pray for Debbie's male friend. We pray for all those who are struggling with health issues. We thank you to have Misty and Diane with us this morning with a good result. Lord, we lift them up to you and many more who need your presence, your healing, your love, and your strength. Yes, O Lord, when we feel lonely, you are with us, surrounded us, O God, with your grace and your peace. Hear our prayers as we come to hear the word of God this morning. As we continue to live our lives to reflect our identity in Christ. And let us, O God, thanks for the blessing of our church as we celebrate 6 years of ministry. Let us be a church in this community to share the good news and bring hope to those who join us and to those that we may encounter in our faith journey. May your blessing reach out to those who are watching us online and those who wish to be with us but are unable to make it, O Lord. We come together knowing, O God, that you hear our prayers. We entrust our lives and surrender our all to you, for you are ours and we are yours. We love you, Lord, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory. Scripture reading this morning will be coming from Isaiah 5:1-7. I will sing for the one I love a song about his vineyard. My loved one has a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He dug it up and cleared it of stones and planted it with choice vines. He built a watchtower in it and cut out a wine press as well. Then he looked for a crop of good grapes, but it yielded only bad fruit. Now you dwellers in Jerusalem and people of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more would you have done for my vineyard than I have done for it? When I look for good grapes, why did it yield only bad? Now I will tell you that I am going to do to my vineyard. I will take away its hedges, and I will destroy it. I will break down its walls, and it will be trampled. I will make it a wasteland, neither prune nor cultivate, and roots and thorns will grow there. I will command the clouds not to rain on it. The vineyard of the Lord Almighty is the nation of Israel, and the people of Judah are the vines he delighted in. And he looked for justice, but saw bloodshed, for righteousness, but heard cries of distress. Our second scripture for today is Luke 12:49 through
56. I have come to burn. I have come to bring fire on the earth, and how I wish it would already be kindled. But I have a baptism to undergo, and what constraints I am under until it's completed. Do you think I came to bring peace on earth? No, I tell you, but division. For now on, there will be five in one family divided amongst each other. Three against two, two against three. They will divide, they will be divided. Fathers against sons, sons against fathers. Mothers against daughters, daughters against mothers. Mother-in-laws against daughter-in-laws, and daughter-in-laws against mother-in-laws. He said to the crowd, when you see a cloud rising in the west, immediately you say it's going to rain, and it does. And when the south wind blows, you say it's going to be hot, and it is. Hypocrites, you know how to interpret the appearance of the earth and the sky. How is it that you do not know how to interpret this present time?
The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you, Lord, our Rock and our Redeemer. And all God's people say, Amen. Amen. As I share in our prayers that we'll be celebrating our 60 years of ministry here in this community. Many of you have heard of how this church started. It was started at the county clubs right across the street where people gathered and started to worship. Sunday school was held in the bar. And I know many of your children share that special moment. 60 years of being God's vineyard in this community. From Prophet Isaiah this morning, he sang a love song about God's vineyard. My loved one has a vineyard on the hillside. He dug it up and cleared it of stones and planted with the choicest vines. He built a watchtower in it and cut up a vine press this way. Vineyard is the image of God's vineyard. And vineyard represents the people of God, the people of Israel, his chosen people. And here Prophet Isaiah is telling us that God prepared his vineyard by providing and protecting and leading and watch over them. From the beginning when God made a promise with Abraham that he will be his people, his descendants from generation, and God will take care of his descendants no matter what they will be. And we know the story that the people of Israel ended up being slaves in Egypt. And they cry out to God, and God heard their cry. And he brought them out of Egypt. Through the Red Sea, he protected and saved them from Pharaoh and his armies. He guided and protected throughout the wilderness for 40 years. Because God kept his covenant and his promise, I will be there and guide you and take you to the promised land. Here, Prophet Isaiah said that my loved one has a vineyard on a fertile hillside. It's the best place where he will plant his vineyard.
the people of Israel were brought from Egypt through the wilderness and took them to the promised land, as we heard, the land filled of milk and honey. And not only that, God prepared, but he went through a lot of trouble to take care of his vineyard. He planted well, and many of you have learned about taking care of a vineyard or plants, vines. It takes a lot of work. Isaiah tells us that the farmer first must find his place, the best place where to place his vineyard. And not only that, but also build a watchtower to protect his vineyard. Likewise, that we as a church, this is God's vineyard that brought us this far for 60 years. God has been there from day one, planted here through many of those who have gone and those who are still with us today, and you as vines planted in God's vineyard. And being cared for, we have been taught with the word of God through prayers. God has given us the gift and blessed us in so many ways to be his vines as we are the branches. And hear what happened. After all the hard work that the farmer or the owner of the vineyard has done, there's an expectation to bring forth good grapes or good fruit. But what happened? It yielded only bad fruit. In the other translation, it yielded only wild fruit. In Hebrew, it meant stinky fruit, bad stinky fruit. And now, the owner of the vineyard asked, what have I done for my vineyard that I have done wrong? When I looked at these grapes and yield only bad, what more could I have done for my vineyard? I think we can ask that question to all of us as vines in God's vineyard. What have I done in his church as followers, as believers? I will tell you now, this is what the owner said. I'm going to do what I'm going to do to my vineyard. So often the nations of Israel, when they got into the promised land, they started put their trust in their own strength, their own wealth, instead of keeping that covenant with God. They trust others, the other nations surrounding the nation of Israel. They lived their life with injustice, and they treated others with not being kind and fair and justice. Instead, they take advantage of other people and abuse them. They use their power by doing wrong things and not living a life that God expected of them as a chosen people, as his favorite, to be a righteousness and justice life. What about all of us this morning? How can we relate to this message of how God has loved us and provide for all of us? And now we come to a time that we trust in our strength and make our own decisions according to our need and what we see in our situation with our human knowledge, instead of seeking God and his Holy Spirit to make decisions. So what happened to this vineyard? The owner said, I will take away its hatches and I will destroy. I will break down its wall and let it be trampled. I will make it a wasteland, neither pruned nor cultivated. This is very hard for us to hear, that the owner, as Jesus said, I am the vine
My father is the vineyard owner. Is this what's going to happen if we don't yield good fruit? That he's just going to make it a wasteland and will destroy and no longer provide and protect. And here, Prophet Isaiah said, I will command the clouds not to bring rain. But there's hope. No word. In verse 7 says, the vineyard of the Lord Almighty is the nation of Israel and the people of Judah. The vines, he delighted in it. In the Gospel of Luke, there's also hard to hear when Jesus said, I have come to bring fire on earth. And how I wish it were already kindled, but I have a baptism to earth. When we know that Jesus come to bring peace, remember the night of his birth, the angels sing that he is the Prince of. And we'll all know that Christ is the Son of God that sent to save us. But here in Luke chapter 12, Jesus said, I come to bring fire on earth. Fire is the image of the Holy Spirit that will come to us. Fire can also be to cleanse and to destroy and to burn. But the second part of what Jesus said, I have come, I have a baptism to undergo. What does that mean? That Jesus knows that he will die for you and for me. For his vineyard, we are his bride. Not only that God loves us and will provide for us, but he delighted in his vineyard for all of us, but we must come and to be captured. We must go through hardship and many challenges of life. And Jesus continued to say, from now there will be five in the family. There will be two against three. There will be divided father against son and son against father. Is that what we see here today? Yes, we know that Jesus come to bring peace, but in such a way that God, Jesus, will come to divide us. The true follower, who are the good vines, and who are those that don't trust and obey God and be stubborn, and those will be divided from those who have been faithful to God. And what Jesus is saying in chapter 12, that there will be a time that he will be taken, will be baptized, and he will go through the cross and give his life to bring peace to all of us. So as part of God's vineyard, that we are called to bear fruit, and the only way that we can bear fruit is to trust God and hear God's call for each and every one of us. For God has placed us in this place, the best place where we can do. We are God's vineyards, and we are gifted by many blessings, and God will take care of us. Yes, the Lord returned to be with his Father, and he sent his Holy Spirit. We are his favorite. We are his delight. Yes, there are things that might happen in this world, but if we stand strong and come as united in faith and baptism for Jesus Christ, taking the cross and baptizing into giving his life and share his blood for the forgiveness of our sins, we just put our faith and trust in him. And when we all trust in God and God alone, we will bear fruit, the fruit of the Spirit that reflect in how we live our life. And the vineyard of the Lord Almighty is the nation of Israel. It's a church of no word. It's you and I. For we are his delight. For Jesus already paved the way for all of us. Whatever challenges that we may encounter, whatever divided, whatever abuse, injustice, and what's happening in our world, be strong because Jesus has overcome. And when we become the follower of Christ, and we know that Christ is with us through His Holy Spirit, we will bear fruit. Fruits that not only allow us to be in the kingdom of heaven after here on earth, but fruits that we reflect who God is in our lives, that wherever we are, we will share that fruit with others. We are God's vineyard, and we are so grateful that God provided for us. He'll let us grow. He'll give us the joy and the blessing and all the gift with an expectation. And with that expectation, you will yield the best fruit. And that fruit of spirit, we will have love and joy, peace, patience, goodness, self-control, faithfulness, kindness. And when we have all those fruits in, and God is delighted and pleased with His vineyard, that we will bear more than we expected, because that is the power of God. This story reminds us that we belong to God. We're not just come to church for ourselves and for our own benefit. There's an expectation for us to bear fruit here on earth. And when Jesus returns, we'll join Him together. Name will be written on the book of life, and we will be in the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Let us come together and present our gift and offering in response to God.
Thank you.
hymn, Be Thou My Vision, United Methodist Hymnal 451.
Patient.